instruments. My presentation is case study about one specific trench at Eastern Front and what we can try to take of computers in archaeology. First of all, some history. Great War in its first phase, and on the Eastern Front, see the great advance of Russian forces into West. Their main attack was hit against Poland in the north, and but on the southern side of this advance was Carpathian Mountains, where they was stopped once because it wasn't the main way of attack, and second thanks to these mountains. But at this place was Russians under command of General Brusilov. He was very active and he nearly reached into the Carpathians to Carpathian Basin. And if he done it, maybe First World War finished earlier for Austro-Hungary, because in Hungarian plain it's very hard to defend. Here in Carpathians was stopped by with all possible Austrian forces with German help. Front was here from November 1914 to May 1915. During these actions here was lost about nearly 40,000 killed soldiers and 250,000 was wounded or captured. Austro-Hungarian forces against this make their own offensives because in the rear of front was still siege fortress Przemyśl, but the both sides can't make the final step to move. After May 1915, there was a big offensive at Gorlice-Tarnów of the Germans and Austro-Hungarians, and after this, Russians was pushed back to the Ukraine. Here is our area of interest, Nordic borders. Here is Slovakian part of First World War. Our locality, our site Staviska, is on the most western part. Near more west wasn't Slovakian involved in the First World War. This site here is Przemyśl, and here this place named Kobila is our second site, but where was very hard fighting, but it is not today topic. Here is the third localization, it's Eastern Slovakia. Here are some of our study localities, sites, and here this number is Staviska. It's exactly at the borderline with Poland. It's about 170 kilometers from Krakow. It's here. Landscape of Carpathians is made by steep hills with agriculture and forestry is here not too much extensive, so it's good for preservation of reeds. So our trenches are good visibly by eye, by ladder, by all. From a military look, Carpathians are quite good natural barrier between Poland and Slovakia. Hungary this time, with just several mountain passes. Our initial aims of survey, when we go to Slovakia, was quite blind. We don't know where we go. So our first goal was cooperation with local universities and heritage organizations, checked. Site evaluation, checked. Documentation and interpretation of the remains, we still work on it. And comparison and confrontation with historical records, still work on it. Our methods of survey are quite simple because LIDAR survey on Slovakian side is not done yet, especially on eastern parts. So we speak about this site, what I have today, because it's on Polish border, so we used Polish data. Thank you for this. And we are quite limited to this. Next, we use GIS, metal detector survey, mostly draw and photo documentation, and sometimes we try 3D modulation and photogrammetry. Our sources are period manuals, handbooks, military intelligence and reports, like plans, and historical photographs and memories. Now we go finally to site. Our local activities at this place are quite famous for Czech, in Czech Republic, because here at the Mická Huta was completely destroyed 28th Infantry Regiment from Prague, and both sides use it for the for use for show how Czech soldiers are good or bad in this war. For Russian, it's about Czech soldiers don't wanna fight against Russians, and for Austria, Czech soldiers are not good. But in fact, we made a little survey there. There was quite a heavy fight about this, and losses on Czech on 28th regiment was quite high too. After these activities, the front move will start. Here, where is this green, is our place, our site. And since 3rd April until 5th May, was this line untouched. Occupied by Tyrol Jäger Regiment number 4 from South Tyrol, with little help of Landwehr Infantry Regiment 27 from Lublin, and some few days here was rest of Infantry Regiment 28, and there are some cavalry to mark in map. This Staviska, Austro-Hungarian trench, it's a quite tight, quite tight hill. Here was built trenches. This is slope is quite tight. It's hardly reached. Enemy is somewhere here. You can see this is me trying to reach the ridge. And in the old mapping, it's visible. This hill was forested even in this old times. So this is made for visibility. I will show later. So we make some slope analysis. Here in this blue circle is this ridge. Here are positions of Russians. Here are positions of Austro-Hungarians. When we make slope analysis and we try to see least post path, when Russians can attack here, but this is quite like wall, so they must turn and encircle, and here is a valley they can use. But it's quite bad for, because here we can use it for try to see how Austrians can build the defense, because they can come with these ways and they can prepare for it. So here we can compare a division plan period from reality. You can see we can use it just for this comparison, but not for georeferencing. They make it how they have time. Sometimes they don't have time. So it's just from eye. Uh, There we are locality site surface survey. We can see, you can see the trenches are well preserved. At ALS, it's good visible too. Here is the light, here is this corner. And here our draw of this corner, where we can see types of objects and objects in the rear. Where we can make imagination of defense, how it looks, where they have key points, especially focus on these objects, I will specify later. Here are more roofs at the site. There is quite rocky soil, so they must use stones, build these trenches into the stone and use a wall of this. These walls are still preserved. Here are some looks for better imagination. This is good visibility, this trench line. This is not the way, it's not counted in. Here is how this hill, DN, slope, and here especially slope, you can see even in the slope analysis, this trench, how the ridge is tied. Here we can see some terraces where we found rear objects. Here again, comparison with period plans. This is divisional plan. We must zoom in quite a bit, quite too much, to just this corner, which is enough for archaeological survey. We used interpretation of object based on comparison with period manuals. Here is photos how here is from handbook how it would look. Here is some photos how it was in reality. It is from Carpathians. They covered trenches with logs and ground. This is how to look position for machine gun. We tried at some places to make photogrammetry, and after this, from this photogrammetry, we tried to make some reconstructions for better imagination. Here it's reconstruction is quite good. Just you can see here the stone walls around. It's in default snow. The most important in this part was localization of heavy guns, because as you can see on divisional plans, here are marked machine guns. And we have, from this period of 1 month, we have few plans. And every plan is this machine gun at different position. Or at different positions, they are, these machine guns are. They change position, maybe, or how will they draw it. So we try to use it on our plan. If we know how machine gun position could look, and with comparison, it could be this place, maybe this place. But after, you can take a photo from this time, and you can see they use. Just traverse in trenches to put this machine gun, and it is perfectly fit to this place. But this is not correlating with these plans, because in these plans mostly the machine guns was at this way oriented. Well, I try line of sight from Australian positions. Here is this line. Red part is what they couldn't see. I tried, even we found some positions before trenches for watch and this. Here is one. Even with this position, there are quite big places they can see. Strange was, these machine guns was oriented perfectly to these places where they can see. So this is still a question. But this line of sight make a response why they built a trench on the place when, where they couldn't. In the handbook is written not put the trenches on this type of position on the ridge, but mostly behind to not be at the line of fire from enemy. But here the ridge was tight, and if we were used, here are positions of Russians. This is perfectly on the edge of visibility. So they maybe can shoot at them, but they will not hit them. It's far and it's at the edge of visibility, so behind, it was behind the in trenches. And they put rear objects very close to the line against the headbook. And this is a answer is it was not visibility because it was behind the ridge. So conclusion is we can reconstruct the face of trench line. With this reconstruction, we can imagine organization of defense and like a place. We can understand why those positions built not directly and often against period official manuals. But we open new question about light of sight and limits of defense. And so our research continues.